for humanity, it's time for general ignorance, so fingers on buzzers, if you please. Name the fastest human runner of all time.
Ah, now.
I'm going to go Usain Bolt.
Well, he is. Did you not watch it? It was on telly.
He's called Bolt, for God's sake. What more do you want?
The argument for him being one of the fastest is strong, but...
him winning and being the fastest?
He won that race.
He won that race, yes. But,
humans...
but you think you're faster, too.
I know, I think I am. I think T8 was faster.
T8?
T8.
Who's that?
It's a fossilised footprint in Australia of an Aboriginal people. And you can tell from the strides that they ran really fast.
What were they running from?
The white man.
Yeah, possibly. Good reason to. Usain Bolt can reach 27 miles per hour for a second to...
Which is very, very impressive. But again, rabbits run at 35 miles an hour. And that's much more exciting.
Yeah. It is not as fast as a rabbit.
It's not as fast as Jimmy Carman. It's his round.
Hey. 20,000 years ago, on the Gold Coast, they discovered these footprints. One of the males was running at 23 miles per hour, but... All right. So Usain Bolt can travel 27 on a running track with spiked shoes, whereas T8 was in mud, barefoot, and was accelerating. I don't know how much faster he got. It seems likely that he was faster than Bolt. And anyway, it's quite likely also that he wasn't the fastest of his 150,000-strong tribe. So anthropologists believe that he, you know, he could have gone up to about 28 miles.
I mean, Usain Bolt wasn't being chased by a lion, was he?
There is also that, yeah, that's
true.
For
all we know, he could have been like a fat bloke who was about 45. Yeah. And all the others were really fast.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
Like 48 miles an hour. How do they actually tell? Is it the stride length?
I think it is. I mean, it's, yeah, stride length, depth of impress. You can be pretty accurate about it.
Maybe they just had a rock in the shape of a foot and they did it for a laugh.
Maybe.